Every day, more than 50,000 Venezuelans cross the border to Colombia to buy food, medicine, and other goods. For some Venezuelan residents, reopening the international bridge means they can go grocery shopping again. During the closure, they had to travel through unsafe rural routes to get to Colombia.
The change has been very good. You go through a lot of work when you use the rural trail.
For months, these rural trails were the only way Venezuelans could reach Colombia. Colombian police shut down these routes for security reasons.
It is very different when you walk in the trails. It's really difficult. Sometimes the flow of the river is high, and it's dangerous for the children.
Now that the border crossing has reopened, local authorities in Cucuta warns that some stores will be forced to limit the sales of goods because of the huge numbers of Venezuelans arriving in the city. It's a cause of concern.
For now, is it just one item that is sold in limited amounts? Some stores just let us buy 4 bags of flour per person.
Some stores at the border are already rationing food sales and raising prices for their goods.
I used to go to the supermarket and buy 6 bags of flour if I wanted. Now it's almost impossible. Lines at the supermarket are long, and I can't even get inside the supermarket. I can stand in that line for more than 2 hours.
Economists warn that the surge of demand could eventually hurt stores that stock too many products.
What is happening is like a bubble. We don't know when it's going to burst. Venezuelans keep coming to buy food. What if they stop? Stores are going to have all this amount of food and no one to buy it.
Rationing food is one of the problems this border city is now dealing with every day, as the political and economic crisis in Venezuela continues with no end in sight. For Jeider Gato in Cucuta, Colombia, Cristina Caicedo Smit, VOA News.